근데 I shall talk about the Gaussian expansion method and its application to nuclear physics with strangeness. I'm Emiko Hiyama from Kyushu University and Riken. So in the neutron rich and proton rich nuclei, and once we assume the nucleus as a two kind of a class nuclear structure, a new nuclear cluster, then when some neutrons or protons are added to the this cluster nuclei, so the additional neutrons are located outside the cluster nuclei due to the Pauli blocking effect. As a result, we have a neutron or proton halo structure in these nuclei. So there are many interesting phenomena in this field, as you know. So it is considered that the nucleus was hardly compressed by the additional nucleons. So now we have a question. So if in this one lambda particle is added to this nuclei, how is the structure modified? So there is no Pauli principle between the nucleons and lambda, then lambda can reach deep inside an attractive surrounding nucleus toward the interior of the nucleus. So then lambda particle plays a groove-like role to produce a dynamical construction of the core nucleus. So, and also that this we call groove-like role lambda particle provides us with interesting phenomena. Namely, if this lambda particle is injected to this and level structure of the core nucleon, now we assume that this blue line is just a level structure of the nucleus, and this green line is the neutron decay threshold. Then, and this due to the this attraction of the lambda interaction, this resultant hypernucleus will become more stable against this neutron decay. So this is a schematic illustration of the nuclear chart with strangeness. Now, so the, here is a non-strangeness sector, and this is a neutron number, and this is a proton number. And here, we have an interesting phenomena concerning neutron halo. So this neutron halo has been observed near the neutron drip line of the neutron drip line of the light nuclei. So if we have the one lambda to the this state, this sector, then we have S minus one sector, namely such as lambda or sigma hypernuclei. And then also, and we can have one more lambda to this sector, then we have this S minus one sector, such as double lambda hypernuclei or cascade hypernuclei. So people can add it to more many lambda to this sector, the extreme limit of the multi-strangeness system is like a neutron star. Then hypernuclear physicists are quite interesting in this sector. But many people are quite interested in this sector. So now we have a question. How does the halo structure change when the lambda particle is injected into this unstable nucleus? So then for this purpose, so far experimentally, they observed this hypernuclei, named helium-7 lambda system, which consists of the helium-6 plus lambda particle. They observed this system at Jefferson Laboratory in 2013. So then we are so interested in solving this system as a four-body system. So then in order to solve the four-body system accurately, so far we use the Gaussian expansion method, which is a kind of a variation method using the Gaussian basis function, and the method takes all the set of Jacobi coordinates. This method has been developed by Kyushu University group, namely Kamimura and his collaborators, including myself. So this method has been applied to the high pressure calculation to the of the various three and four body system, such as exotic atomic system and three and four nuclear system, and so on. So let's talk about this helium-7 lambda system. So core nucleus, helium-6 is one of the lightest neutron-rich nuclei. Then this helium-7 lambda is one of the lightest neutron-rich nuclei, a neutron-rich hypernuclei. So then before measurement of the helium-7 lambda, in this paper, we predict the energy spectra of helium-7 lambda. Namely, this is the core nucleus of helium-6, and we have a 0+ state, bound state, and 2+ resonance state. So once we add it to the lambda particle to the each state, then due to the glue-like role of lambda particle, we have very stable energy spectra like this. And this is ground state of the helium-6 lambda, and lambda separation energy, we predict the 5.636 MeV. And recently, they observed the lambda separation energy like this. And then, in comparison with this experiment data, and our result is not inconsistent with experimental data. And also, we predict that this excited bound state, namely, so this is composed of the 2 plus of helium 6 plus lambda, which is located in the 0s orbit. Then, due to the spin-spin interaction, we have this state. And this red line is very close to this green line threshold, then we predict to have a Harrow state like this. So then after this prediction, and at the Jefferson laboratory, they observed so this excited state. According to experiment data, they reported the lambda excitation energy is like this, and also our calculation result is like this, which is in good agreement with my prediction. So now we have another question. In helium-7 lambda, do we have any other new state? If so, what is spin and parity? So then in order to answer this question, first let us discuss about energy spectra of helium-6 core nucleus. So, and then this is experiment data in 2002. We have the Harrow state of the ground state of 0 plus state, and also we have a resonance state of the 2 plus state. And then above that is 2 plus state, also they reported very broad resonance state, but so it was difficult to assign the spin and parity. And then in 2012, they observed the another new state, like the second 2 plus state, energy is like this, and gamma is like an 2 MeV, like this. So now it is interesting to compare the theoretical result. For example, we show that one of the theoretical results by Myo-san, and then so in the case of the 0 plus state ground state, so his calculational energy is good agreement with the data, and also first 2 plus state is good agreement with the data. And also he also predicts the second 2 plus state like this, and in comparison with experiment data, and the energy is a little bit so higher than the observed data, and gamma is a little bit broader than the experiment data. So, what is my result? Also, I'm interested in calculating first core resonance state energy of helium-6 lambda. But you can see this is observable data again, and this 2 plus state are resonance state. Then I should obtain energy position and decay radius. To do so, now I use the compressed scale method, which one of the powerful methods to get the resonance state. So this is my result of the helium-6. You can see that this is a continuum state, and also here is also continuum state of the helium-5 to minus state plus nucleon. And you can see that we have a 2 pole, and this is the first 2 plus state, and this is the second 2 plus state. And energy is a 0.96 MeV, and this is a gamma, and this is also energy for the second 2 plus state, and this is a decay radius. So now also we can compare our result with the experiment data. And in the case 0 plus and first 2 plus state, so all these 2 states are good agreement with the experiment data. And in the case of the second 2 plus state, energy is a little bit above the observed data, and gamma is too broad than the experimental data. So now we are interested in considering about energy spectra of helium-7 lambda system. So then here, this energy is again of the core nucleus helium-6 energy spectra. Now let's add it 1 lambda to the each state. So then we can see that also energy pole of the second fifth half plus state like this. So energy is a source like this, and gamma is 1 MeV. So this energy is measured with respect to the alpha, lambda, and n threshold. So now we summarize the energy spectra of the helium-7 lambda. You can see that, and we have a ground state and also first three half plus state and three half plus state. And also we have second three half plus state, three half state above the alpha and n threshold. Here is energy, and this is a decay width. So this is correspond to this second two plus state. So then that we propose experimentalist to measure this state. So in order to propose this state, I think it is necessary to estimate the reaction cross-section by this electron scattering. So now, according, this is the estimation of the diffraction cross-section of the each state, you can see. And then according to experiment data, they already observed this state. So then comparing with this estimation, this second three half plus state, fifth half plus state is a 40% reduction in comparison with this. However, I think that it is possible to measure that this state in the future. So then I propose experimentalists to propose this state in the future at JPAR, Jefferson Laboratory again. So thank you for the attention.